Hello and welcome back to another video with It's Dr. Dan, and today we're going to be learning about the tips and tricks on how to convert a Haworth projection to a Fisher projection in introductory biochemistry. Now, one of the ways that you learn all about how to show different simple sugars or carbohydrates is by drawing a Fisher projection just like the one shown here, where you might draw the enantiomers, you might label all the chiral carbons, the epimers, the diastereomers. Whether it's an aldose or a ketose, you'll show reactions. But as we realize that sugars do not simply generally exist like this, we always show them as these different type of ring structures over here, known as a Haworth projection. Now, in most courses, they focus on going from Fisher to Haworth, but very rarely do they talk about, well, how do you go backwards? How do you disassemble it to be able to label what sugar it is? What is the easiest way to do this? And that's what we're going to show in this video, is the little tips and tricks, step by step, how to break down one of these in a very quick and easy way. We're going to go through two different molecules to illustrate this. So let's take a look at the different steps, and thank you so much for stopping by, and let's look at and try to learn and conquer how to do this. The first step that we're going to be doing is we number our carbons. And the thing is, when we are looking at these rings, we have to figure out what the anomeric carbon is. So whenever we are finding our anomeric, we need to find what we call a hemiacetal or a hemiketal. So we're looking for a signature. And whenever we're looking for this, I always like to say we're looking for the little set of googly eyes that you see in the molecule. So for example, if I kind of have one of a these little hemiacetals here, you can kind of just imagine that has two little eyeballs on it with some little kind of little eyebrows above it. And these are your eyeballs that are here. You're looking for the two oxygens that are on these molecules, and they're both connected to the anomeric carbon, which is right here, as I'm kind of showing here in purple. It's that little dot. Those are your anomerics. So if we go to the structure over here, you want to try to give the anomeric carbon the lowest number possible. And what we can see here is, well, you can notice that we do have an anomeric carbon where these two O's are connecting to this single point. So this is what we're going to give the number one. So we number around the ring. So it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we're going to number it as if it's a chain and continue the numbering outside. So number 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now, other things that are really important to try to remember as well is whether or not it's alpha or beta, because sometimes in your course, you might have to label that. Now, it's pretty straightforward how to do it. So if you kind of look at, let's say, this OH here that I'm now highlighting in teal and the CH5OH, notice how they're both together. Together meaning same, this is cis. So in this case, if they're both pointing up together or both pointing down together, that's referring to cis. So what we have here is a beta ring structure because they are together. If the OH was, let's say, if it was pointing on the other end, and if I were to switch it, let's say I put it here, and it was pointing down, now they're both opposite of each other. This is referred to as alpha or trans. In order to kind of remember those, there's a little trick that I learned that I kind of like. If you kind of look at the alpha symbol and I put like little dots going down the side, notice how essentially the little tails of the alpha are both pointing in opposite directions. So that's how you can kind of remember trans. Whereas with cis, notice how the two humps of the B are together, right? They both are together like a little heart. They go together, right? Step two, we're going to draw the Fisher projection backbone. Now, before we can do that, we have to be able to label whether this is an aldose, meaning an aldehyde, or a ketose, meaning a ketone. Now, the way that we do this, we look at the anomeric carbon and we count where it was. So if it's at number 1, that means that it's an aldehyde. If it's at number 2, it's a ketose. Now, when we numbered the structure from earlier, we saw that at number 1, this is our anomeric carbon, meaning that we're going to have an aldose. So what you're going to first do is you're going to write that you have an aldose here. So we have C double bond O, H, and we're going to write that on our structure. Now the next thing is we're going to draw our lines for our backbone. So what I do is I just draw a little spine here, And you're going to end it with the CH2OH, which is on carbon number 6 from our original structure, okay? Now, all the other spots are your chiral carbons. So 2, 3, 4, and 5 are all chiral carbons. So you need to draw a little flat line for each of these spots. So we have 2, 3, 4, and then 5, okay? So we have each of those spots, 1, 2, let's number them as well. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the last one is 6. Now, the last thing is, before we move on to our next step, is depending on where that CH2OH is at number 6, if it's pointing up or down, tells you where your last chiral OH is, so on carbon number 5. So if it was pointing up, that means that it's a D enantiomer. If it's pointing down, it's an L enantiomer, which is really important because that tells you, hey, which direction it's going to be. On our original structure, you can see that the CH2OH here was pointing up. So what that's going to let you know is, hey, we're going to put this going to the right on our structure. So we have one of our pieces here. Let's go into the next step to see a quick and easy way to fill in the rest of this. Step number 3 is what I consider a pro tip, being I've done so many of these in my own personal teaching career. The easiest way to do this is if you draw a line down the bold part of the Hayworth projection, which shows the wedge characteristic, so which is on the bottom here. So what I do is whenever I'm visually looking at these, I draw a little imaginary line down the middle. So if I do that here, so where this little wedge is, I'm drawing these little dots to kind of illustrate how I'm going to be looking at this structure. Now, depending on where everything is, you can actually quickly see how to fill in your Fischer projection that is on the left here. So what we're going to do is once you write that line, we are just going to turn it slightly. So we're going to turn it just like this. And what it's going to do, so I turned it back, so I turned it 90 degrees to the left. And what this is going, this actually shows you is where to put all your OHs. So if we look at carbon number 2, notice how the OH is pointing to the right. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to write OH, and I'm going to put that pointing to the right. Okay, so I have OH, H. Now on carbon number 3, notice how the OH is pointing to the left-hand side. So I'm going to put an OH pointing to the left. Now on carbon number 4, it's on the right-hand side of my dotted line. So we're going to fill that in as well. Now we have our complete structure. Now, if you're not able to turn that on your own very easily, you can always turn your paper or your notebook just to kind of show how to do that. Another easy way to do it is that if it's on the upper side of the dotted line, is that upper means equals left. And if it's down, that means that equals right, okay, when it comes to filling in all these other chiral carbons. Do not get it confused with carbon number 5. That one's different. So let's try to identify which molecule this is, which is the last step, is we're going to name and identify our Fischer projection. Our next step is that we're going to name and identify what our structure is. When you're trying to identify these, it can be really complicated, especially when you have a lot of different molecules in front of you. The first thing I would recommend doing is classifying your structure, meaning that we have an aldohexose, so it's an aldehyde with 6 carbons, and that will help you limit down all the types of diastereomers and enantiomers you're going to be looking at. We also know that we have a beta, or in our case was a beta D version of this structure as well, being it was cis in the beginning, and our last OH group is going to the right. So the quick way to look at this structure is how to identify it is I look at one side of the molecule. So in this case, what I'm looking at is I see that I have OH, H, OH, OH. So I'm going to match one side. So when we're looking, we're going to try to find OH, H, OH. So if I look at, let's say, like looking at the first one, right, allose doesn't match, altrose doesn't match. Wait, that's H, OH, OH. Now, if I look at glucose, that one is OH, H, OH, OH. So that is a quick way to kind of identify, like, hey, do you have the right one? So you can also circle, let's say, the OHs as well and see, like, okay, which one matches the same pattern. So you're trying to figure out, like, okay, where is everything situated? So what this tells us is the one that we're working on is beta D glucose, which is the name of our molecule. Let's take a look at another one to practice looking at all these configurations and putting it all together. Okay, let's put it all together going through our steps. So here we have, I want you to draw the Fischer projection and name it. How would you do it? So the first thing we said to do is we're going to number our carbons and try to give the anomeric the lowest one possible. So once again, what we're going to do is we're looking for our little eyeballs. And what you can see here is, looking at the structure, is right here, is that you have the two OHs, both kind of meeting here at the exact same spot. So what this tells you is that here is your anomeric carbon. We'll use a little star to tell us that. Now, one thing you'll notice is that you don't want to just automatically assume it's number one. You got to look if there's any carbons that are currently next to it. And we see that we have one. So meaning that this one's a ketose. It's starting at this point. So what we'll do is we number that number one. We go number two, number three, number four, and then we have number five, and we follow the carbons around as if it's in a chain, right? The ring is also can exist as a chain. So you need to show both. So we have six carbons, and we notice that it's starting at a CH2OH. So what we're going to do is write CH2OH at the top. Now, being it's a carbon number two, that's letting you know, hey, we have a ketone in this case. So we have C double bond O. And what we're going to do is just to kind of help illustrate that, we'll keep our numbering with the same colors. So we got one, two. Now, at the very end of the chain, we know it's CH2OH is our last piece. Okay, so now we have all of our pieces. We'll put in our chiral carbons. We should have a total of six total. So we have one, two, three, four, five, six. All right, now our last step was putting that little dotted line in place to determine where the OHs go. So I'm going to put a little dots here across the bottom to kind of help us see the trend. Because we need to figure out where does carbon three and four go on this molecule. And the same thing with carbon number five as well, which was our last CH2OH. So if we go in order, carbon number three is going down, which means that it's on the right-hand side. And if it helps too, we can turn the molecule as well to help show that. What we can see is that, okay, the first OH is pointing to the right-hand side. On carbon number four, it's pointing towards the opposite, which is the left. So let's do that here. So we have already have three filled in. Number four, we're going to put O, then H. Now, carbon five depends on where is the last CH2OH pointing. Is it pointing up or down? In this case, it's pointing down. So that means that it's going to be on the left-hand side is where that's going to go. So we are going to put that in. So it's telling you, hey, you have an L configuration in your molecule. So let's kind of write that. And we also have alpha as well. So we have alpha L. And the way that I could tell if it's alpha is we see we have one OH pointing up, the other one pointing down. So they're both opposite sides. So let's try to name and identify what we have. So if I were to do this, the thing is that's more common is most monosaccharides tend to be given to you as the D configuration, right? In most reference sheets, they're the more common because you biologically tend to find D configuration in the body. So being that we have an L carbon here, right, because the OH is on the left, what we have to do is we have to draw its mirror image first. So if we were to do that, so let's kind of make our little mirror here. And what we're going to do is we're going to copy this down and flip all of the chiral carbons in our molecule. So we'll redraw this, just like redraw the backbone, just like so. Now we're going to fill in all of our OHs to mirror each other. So what we have here is we have OH, then OH, OH, and I'll fill in all the hydrogens, H, H, H. So that way we have both the L and the D configuration. So we got L and then D. All right, so on our D configuration, what we need is we need OH, we need left, right, right for our configuration. So if we were to look here, left, right, right, what we can see really quickly is that fructose matches left, right, right here at the bottom. So that's letting you know that, oh, your structure that you have is fructose. So to name our original molecule, this is going to be alpha L fructose is going to be the name of it. So this is my tips and tricks on how to do these, how to go backwards. So hopefully this helped you a little bit to see, like, just draw a little line down the middle. It makes it a lot faster to do it, right? You can do it in just a few minutes. Thank you for listening. If this video did help you, please feel free to share it, like it, subscribe to the channel for more introductory organic and biochemistry videos. Thank you all, and I hope you have a wonderful day. Bye now.